We are back down in the basement once again. It's Dan Veall here for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and we are looking at this rather cool Nordstrand Acinonyx bass. Now, there is lots to say about the background of this instrument, but I will immediately point you towards the written review in Guitar Interactive for more information about that, because this little chap has got a lot under its bonnet that I want to cover in this review. So go and seek out the written review now and come back and check out the rest of the video. Okay, so what do we have here? Well, this is really interesting actually. Nordstrand Audio, Kerry Nordstrand, is well known for being a great name in the world of electronics and pickups. And this guy knows tone. So when it comes to creating a bass, it's no surprises that this thing sounds pretty damn cool. What I'm going to do, as usual, is head up to the headstock end of business. We'll work all the way down the bass, and then we're going to have a look at what's going on here and some of the sound settings you can get from this bass, which are a little bit unusual, but man, do they sound really cool. Up at the headstock end, we've got this really cool reverse headstock type layout. E string on the top of the headstock and then the rest of the strings underneath. Now, I really love this. My two favorite electric guitars at home are reverse headstocks, so this immediately caught my eye and went, oh yeah, that's really interesting. Tuning keys wise, let's flip the bass over and have a look at what is going on there. We have custom hipshot lightweight tuning keys, and don't these look really, really superb? Nice layout there. Open gear, not a lot of metal work on them. This bass is already crazy light, weighing in a mere 3 kilos-ish. Having the lightweight tuning keys is only going to help that, especially as it's on the headstock, less pulling down on the shoulder for really, really long gigs. Whilst we're here, let's do the whole back of the body. Let's come all the way down and see what's going on, and then we'll flip the bass back over. The neck is skinny. It is superb. I'm reading this as a 35.5mm nut. So, you know, it's skinnier than your average jazz bass. And it is super smooth, super skinny. This is going to be brilliant for little hands. And actually, I've got massive hands, and I'm still not having any problems with this. Down onto the back of the body, we have got a bolt-on neck here and some really nice rounded edges. And this glorious red color, beautiful. Okay, let's go back up to the headstock. We'll work down the fretboard and then we'll get on to some of the sounds on board. So, as I said, we have got a 35.5mm nut. Down onto the fretwork, this is absolutely beautiful. And one of the things I really like actually is I like offset markers. You know, don't get me wrong, traditionally I like dots down the middle of the fretboard, but you know, if you're going to have an instrument with a bit of quirky in style, well, let's move the dots somewhere interesting as well. So on the treble side, big dots. These can be fantastic, especially on dark stages or if like me, the old ailing eyesight. So there we go, nice big dots. And on the treble, the bass side of the fretboard, if I flip it over, dot markers as well, like that, so we can see where we are. Okay, now coming down the scale length, we have got an Indian rosewood fretboard here, and it's just a smidge over 30-inch scale length, so this is a short scale bass, and it's got that lovely warm, springy kind of tone to it, which I've come to expect from some of the shorter scale length instruments that I have reviewed over the years. Even though it's a smaller bass and, you know, I'm a fairly tall guy, this does not feel uncomfortable at all. Whereas I have to say there's been maybe a couple of reviews that I've done where I felt a little bit like I was almost having to squeeze into it. There seems to be plenty of space on this. I wonder what's going on. Maybe Kerry can tell us. Coming down then, off the neck into the bodywork, we have got two custom pickups. And as I said, I can put some information in the written review about these, but we've got a couple of blades in here with lots of lovely thick wire in there. And that translates, as I understand, to nice fat tone. And what am I hearing? Nice fat tone. Two pickups, master volume, no tone control. What's going on? When I play, I tend to find maybe a couple of settings that I use constantly, like fully open, fully closed, 50-50. But sometimes when I'm gigging, it's kind of difficult to go and find that setting, especially if you're switching between parts really, really quickly. So wouldn't it be handy if you had a preset where you could just go for it and know that it's in exactly the right position all the time? Well, this appears on this very instrument. So we've got the pickup selector over here, which we're going to play with in just a moment. But over here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 switches. Now, you're not going to see this, but I'm going to roll the bass forward. And you're going to have to take my word for it. There are actually little icons on top of the buttons. And they give me an idea about what these controls do. But after a while, you just remember them anyway. So at the moment, I've kind of selected what would be bypass for the tone control. It's fully open, and we're hearing all of the glorious tone from the pickups. So this is both pickups on with that setting and a little bit of fingerstyle. Quick noodle there, and hopefully you can hear how the two pickups are interacting with each other, and I've got a lovely clear top end as well. But number two, we have got what would be a classic mild top end roll off. Let's play something similar again, and you can hear the difference that makes. It's not too much top end, it's just taking the sparkle off, but I've still got that lovely woody, round sound. Now, if you're like listening to this and going, well, I can't hear any difference, then put on some decent earphones, listen on some decent speakers, laptop speakers and earbuds are not going to translate the sound of this really cool bass. So, that's you told. Okay then, next setting is a much steeper roll off. So we're getting a fatter low end and less top end. I used this in one of my little intro ditties a moment ago. Okay, here we go. Nice. Again, still plenty of wood, plenty of mid-range there. It's not scooping away some of my important frequencies, that sort of 200 to 400 sort of region. That's still nice and solid in the sound. We need that. Okay, and then position number four is a mid-scoop. So if you're playing through a combo with, you know, probably too much mid-range and you can't seem to tame it, bang, you'll find that this will be very, very useful. This is what this one sounds like. So just with two pickups on all the time, I can go through my four settings and I've got four instantly usable sounds. And I noticed that immediately as soon as I picked up this bass for the first time, which actually wasn't that long ago. So now I've got my tone controls. Over here, I have a four-way selector here. Now the eagle-eyed amongst you will notice that we've actually unfortunately found that there's a knob missing this bass out of the box. We did search, we did have a look, and unfortunately we couldn't find it. So this is going to be a one-off. You know, Nordstrand are not going to make a habit of this. So it's going to be just like, you know, something you'll find the right amount of button knobs on your bass straight out of the box. So we're going to just imagine there's one there. No problem at all. It still works absolutely fine. Okay, four switches. At the moment, we have been playing with both pickups on. This is button number one. Button number two is this lovely, deep, round sounding neck pickup. Let's listen to that one on its own and I'm gonna go for fingerstyle again. And obviously, it's going to be the bridge pickup for the next switch. Position number four is a mute switch. How handy is that? Click that, don't even need to touch the volume anymore. That can be really, really useful for changing the bass on stage or maybe on switching between effects and the like. And I can just get the bass to go quiet for a moment. Now, this instrument actually has a hidden setting. We've got the three main settings here, both pickups in parallel, the front pickup we just heard and the rear pickup soloed. But if I actually push all the buttons in together, we get a series setting. Loads more volume there. Obviously, two pickups in series, we're getting that lovely extra mid-range punch going on there. And that is a really, really superb sound. It doesn't sound like a P bass, it doesn't sound like a jazz bass, it definitely doesn't sound like a Music Man. We've got a nice tonal palette to play with here that I think would actually be really, really useful in a wide range of situations. The series setting is certainly one of my favourites, but I also really liked using the front pickup on its own with the tone dialed all the way down. It was sort of reminiscent of the sort of EBO style basses where it's just all plump in the low end and not a lot of top end, but you can still hear some character in there. So really, that's wrapping up the instrument. Of course, I could have gone through and changed all the settings, but we would have been here for much longer. So I'm going to have to tell you that you need to go out and try this out for yourself. It is a lot of fun, super lightweight. I think it would suit really any body size. I'm quite comfortable with it, and it sounds absolutely excellent. So check out my written review. I'll put some more information in there, and of course I will bring you another review again soon. I hope you've enjoyed this one, and I'll see you again.